morning. Yellarigu namaskara. Vanakkam. Namaste. I'm Swarna Latha, born and brought up in Bangalore, now living in Coimbatore from last 6 years. So, I broke all the barriers of language, of sex, of disability, of disease, of beauty, of parenting, and infrastructure. 9 years ago, I was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. Unfortunately, I was diagnosed with a very severe type of multiple sclerosis called the primary progressive type, in which the person affected becomes completely disabled in a matter of few years. So the first time I was diagnosed, my son was 2 years old, and I was neck down paralyzed, and my speech, my vision, my hands, my mobility, everything was affected. After a round of steroids, in 2 months' time, I regained 60% of the mobility that I had, and I lost 40% forever. So whatever that 60% was remaining, I have been losing gradually over these years. And people have seen me walk, then holding support to walk, and then walking stick phase, walker phase. So last 2.5 years, I'm on wheelchair. So we pretty much know where I'm going to be in the future. So without worrying what is going to be happening in the future, I decided to take charge of my life. I actually went into severe depression. I thought I must die, but then I thought I should give life another chance. Lot of people said I won't be able to do this, I won't be able to do that, but I proved everybody wrong, not because I wanted to prove somebody wrong, but because I wanted to give life another chance, because it's worth living. And 2 years later, after my diagnosis, I gave birth to another child, daughter. A lot of people said, I can never be a good mother. My children will never be healthy. But today, my children, both the children, my daughter is 7 years, my son is 11 years, both are national level karate champions. So, my husband, Guru Prasad, and I started visiting hospitals a lot. We used to spend a lot of time in hospitals. So we got into counseling patients initially, not just patients, but their family members too. Coincidentally, my father-in-law also was affected with Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. Both of us pretty much came on wheelchair the same year. And emotionally, financially, physically, mentally, it was a burden for everybody at home having two wheelchair users. So, but then we moved on in life with whatever experiences we had, and a lot of time people said I can never be a good wife. This year, Wedding Wars, India's number one wedding magazine, has honored us with the best couple of the year award. A lot of them said, I can never be useful. I am useless. I can never be useful again. I will never be able to do anything. But I've got 24 awards for the work I've been doing for the society. And this is the Thanga Tharagai award. The last person to receive this award was Kumari J. Jailalta, Chief Minister, ex-Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. Yeah, like I sing quite often, but not ukulele is my first time on stage. I started learning it 3 months back because my fingers don't move well. So I actually chose it to, as a form of exercising. So this is my first performance on ukulele today. Yes. I was also a finalist in the Mrs. Coimbatore Beauty Pageant, and I won the title Mrs. Confidence, and I was the only one on wheelchair there. So, this year in Goa, I was also the first runner-up at the Mrs. India Beauty Pageant South, and I won the title Mrs. Popular. So, a lot of participants said she should not be on stage because she cannot do the ramp walk. I said, if you're going to judge the beauty of a person by the way how he walks or she walks, you must actually conduct a marathon and see who actually walks longer and faster. Then they actually had to take me, and believe me, I was the first runner-up. So I broke all the barriers about beauty and disability. And like, these are my ukulele teachers. I'm also learning keyboard. So a lot of people said people with disabilities cannot donate blood. So Guru and I, this year on the World Blood Donation Day, both of us donated and set new couple goals. Yeah. And I'm also a photographer. This one was taken at the Kotak Wheelchair Marathon in Chennai, and a lot of photos that I click have been displayed in various international exhibitions. I've won prizes for videographies as well on the international level. And I do write short stories, and few of them have got prizes. And I write for various online platforms also. I've been featured in various videos. This one was done with the Election Commission of Tamil Nadu to create awareness about 100% voting. I used to do puppet shows those days to improve my coordination skills. So behind that purple screen, I was performing puppet show. Then later on, I come out and say that, if I can go and vote, what's stopping you? So that was the message, and it was telecast in all news channels as part of the election campaign. And this is the man behind the woman's success. I really don't understand how he can find me so hot, sexy, sensual, in spite of helping me change my soiled diapers. I have to check with him. So, Guru and I decided to start Swarga Foundation. In 2010, I was forced to resign from my job because my company thought I'm unfit to work for them anymore because I became disabled. Today, after starting the organization, I've successfully employed people with disabilities and people with no disabilities. And we are running this organization very efficiently. And initially, we started counseling patients and the caregivers, like I said earlier. And then we started reimbursing patients' hospital bills, medical bills, giving them wheelchairs, walkers, and other mobility aids, supporting 7 children this year for their education. And I have delivered more than 200 talks across India, created awareness about various neuromuscular disorders. And the AM Special Calendar series that we do every year features 12 differently abled achievers from across India. The theme for 2019 is Women of Substance, and the calendar is available here today. Please buy and support us. This is our major fundraiser which supports all our projects. And we have also started Tamil Nadu's first transport facility for people with disabilities and senior citizens. The van comes with a ramp, toilet, sofa cum bed, television, hot water, so that people like us can travel with dignity and comfort. And we have made police commissioner's office in Coimbatore wheelchair friendly by providing them a 35-foot ramp, a toilet, and a parking facility. We made 8 government schools in Coimbatore disabled friendly by providing toilets, wheelchair friendly toilets, and ramps to the classrooms. This year, 15 children on wheelchair have come back to school. Yeah. And we have built disabled friendly toilets on all the platforms of City Railway Station in Coimbatore. Yeah. And I'm also a member of DRUCC to make changes in the railways. We've done various awareness videos. And we have, in association with Nehru Air Rifle Academy, we are providing air rifle training for every person with disability free of cost for lifetime. Yeah, so we have also started Saukhya Physiotherapy Center for people with disabilities. So this center is completely free for everybody who takes service here. And our long-term dream is to have a rehabilitation center. And what I came to know in this journey is you can convert every adversity into an opportunity. And people call us by different names. Disabled, differently abled, Divyangjan, special. But I'm here to tell you that I'm not just special, I'm limited edition. This is Swarnalatha. And I want to tell you the transformation inclusion can bring in anybody's life by singing these two lines. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. Thank you so much. Thank you.